G'day, welcome back to another video. In this video we'll be building this Tamiya Thunder Dragon. Should be pretty cool. Yeah, without wasting any time, let's get into it. Alrighty, so in this build I'll be using 16 1150 bearings and 4 850 bearings. And I'll be using a PIHD 3001 HB servo. And a Futaba R202GF receiver. And a Tamiya GT tune motor. Now, first up, we start building the diffs. So we do the front and rear at the same time, get them out of the way. And can start putting bearings in the gearbox. Got the 1150s there. Put some 850s in too. And you'll notice this one here doesn't need to be a bearing. Because as you can see, the counter gear is locked on the shaft. So that 1150 there can just be one of the bushes. Doesn't matter. That shaft actually spins on those 850 bearings right there. So a lot of sets you see that have 17 bearings in, you only need 16. So moving forward, put the front gearbox together. Got the bearings in there. Got the gears in and all the grease. Fantastic. And we got the diff in there. So time to lock it up. There's our front gearbox. And there's our rear gearbox. Looking pretty good, I think. And there's our GT tune motor. Thought we'd take a bit of time to admire it. So now I've got the motor installed in the gearbox. Got the alloy motor plate there. Looking pretty good. Then it was time to fit up the rear suspension. So we've got the arms and stuff on there. Got the rear bumper on it. And while I was at it, it's time to do the front end. So I got the sway bar on there, got the arms on and stuff. Magnificent. And then straight onto the shocks. So the shocks are all built. You've all seen that before. And then it was time to fit the shocks, front and rear. And if you've got a keen eye here, you'll notice I had the top of the shocks mounted in the wrong hole. They should have been down lower. So I changed that later. And there's our front end with the mono shock on it. Beautiful. After that, straight into the radio. So I've got the servo in there for the steering. On the ESC, I've put a Dean's connector on it. So then it was time to measure our little linkages for the steering. So we've got the steering arm there with a 14mm gap and the two tie rods with an 18mm gap in the middle. After that, I set up the steering mechanism with the linkages and arms and stuff on there. And it was ready to drop in. So there we go. Got our steering set up all in there. Left the bumper off so we could have a look. And that's the underneath of the chassis. So we just got some tidying up to do on the wires and we're almost ready to go. Chassis almost complete. So now I've tidied up the wires. I think it's looking very tidy. And I've run the motor wires up to the other side there and across the back. I'll work out later that's not a good idea because I need to use that screw hole for the chassis cover. And I ended up shortening the battery cable there. You can see it sticking out because it was like about 2 inches too long. So looking over the chassis, I think it looks pretty cool. Got the motor in there looking nice. Tidy wiring, got to be happy with that. As I said, I end up changing where the motor wires are going because where I have that cable tie, I need to put a screw in there in order to keep the motor wires away from the prop shaft too. Then it was time to start on the driver's helmet. So I screwed his helmet together, masked his face off and gave him a good sand. Then I gave it a quick coat of primer and then hit it with some blue. Tamiya TS15. Then after that I thought I'd give him a bit of a razzle dazzle, so I put a bit of clear pearl over the top. Doesn't look perfect here, but it settles down and looks okay. And there it is when it's dry. Done his face. He's got the fire mask on there. So this is the hole I need to use for the chassis cover. So I've moved the motor wires over the other side and tucked them in down the bottom there. I think it looks even neater than before. So I trimmed the chassis cover and tried it on, you know, bit of a test fit. Seems to fit pretty well. So after that, I started painting the driver on the inside using Proline polycarbonate paint. So I just used fine brushes, brushed it on, and the fine shading in the middle, I just used the airbrush for that. And the silver on the racing suit there, I actually mixed silver and white because I wanted a bit of sparkle like the box, but without it being straight up silver. And I used Mulatto, I think you say it, Mulatto chrome on the belt buckles. Did that on the inside too. Then after that, I just used some Tamiya PS5 black to do the rest of the chassis cover there on the inside. So that's the finished result. Got his helmet on there. No, I'm pretty happy with it. It's not perfect. There's no oil painting, but it looks good to me. And his helmet's got a bit of sparkle, as you can see. And not too much on the suit. After that, it was time to get onto the decals. So I trimmed them out just using a hobby knife. And they're all done now, ready to peel off and stick on. Now the fun part, peeling the film off the body. Oh yeah. Now before we get excited putting the stickers on, we've got to make a little hole there for the antenna tube. They say you use a 5mm hole, but I went for 4mm because 5 is a bit too big, I thought. So I used this dynamite body reamer. It's got all your measurements on the tip there. And a nice little cover so you don't prick yourself. So after that, bang the stickers on and we're getting closer. They're all pretty easy stickers. They're all kind of straight lines. And make a little hole in the front decal there for the body mount. So that's it. It's all done. Looks pretty cool, I reckon. I'm happy with it. Turned out nicely. Anyway, I'll leave you with a little montage. You can check it out all up close and see what you think. So I'll get this out soon and give it a run and might even take it out with the Fire Dragon, put them head to head, even though this has got a slow motor in it. Very slow being the GT tuned. So that's about it. If you like the video, give it a thumb up, that'd be great. If you're new here, subscribe, that'd be awesome. And catch you later.